Hey guys, Wells Knight here, and welcome back to another episode of Design Tech. And in today's episode, we are going to be doing a few different things. I've done some work between episodes, did some resource gathering and stuff like that, and we've got double chests just full of stuff, including a lot of clay. We've got, I think, everything we need to set up a tinker's smeltery, so that's definitely one of the first things that I want to do. Let's go ahead and make that and that, and we'll need at least one of those, and let's see how far that, I need a tank, that's right, give me a piece of glass, there we go. I want to do this first before we do anything else, and somewhere, here we go, I also made a portable tank, it's just one copper ingot and then some glass. And I think we're gonna set up our Tinker Smeltery like right about here. And it's just gonna be a really small temporary smeltery. I need to repair my pick. This thing's nearly destroyed. Let's grab one piece of cobble. There we go. And bam, repaired. Beautiful. Okay. So, we're going to go ahead and set this thing up, and let's just go like that. Oh! I don't want that facing that direction. Let's put our controller here, our drain here. Is this... Oh, I made this way bigger than it needs to be. Wow, I'm so good at tinkers. That's terrible. Okay, let's put that there. There we go, that's better. And then we'll put 1, 2, 3. And looks like I need 2 more seared bricks to finish that thing off. And we've got ourselves a smeltery. So we'll put that guy down. And let's go ahead and fill this thing up with lava. There we go. So now we should be able to double our ores and do all sorts of wonderful stuff like this. The reason that this is in a really, that this thing looks horribly ugly and that I'm not really too worried about it is because we're going to be moving before this episode is over. We're going to be packing everything up and moving off to a new location. But there are some things that we need to do before we can do that. For example, doubling a bunch of our ores. So let's do this. Let's go ahead and make a smeltery, a casting basin, and this will allow us to do blocks. So full blocks of stuff. Once these all melt down, we can turn them directly into iron blocks, and this is going to be just a cheap early game way for us to double our ores. I will need more grout and stuff like that as time goes on, but we can worry about that once we get into our more permanent location. The other thing that I made is I made some regular bricks so that we can make the coke oven from Immersive Engineering. There we go. So we'll make 28 of those, and we can just put this down. Well, once again, it's going to be temporary, so I don't feel guilty about putting it here, because ultimately this stuff is going to get torn down as soon as I get some resources processed anyway. So, let's see, that's 3x3. And then I need to make the engineer's hammer. This thing. So, a piece of string, 2 sticks, and an iron ingot. Okay, we can do that. Let's go and put more iron in here. And let's see about making ourselves that hammer. I know I've got a piece of string somewhere. There we go. Do I have any more iron ingots? I do. And, man, my inventory is just a disaster. I can't wait to get moved out so we can get sorted and get our inventory in order. Because right now, this is just not doing it for me. All right, let's go ahead and make the engineer's hammer. There we go. And then we just right-click. Ship right-click? No? Coke oven? I wonder if that's a bug. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I am back. It is a bug. It's an old bug. I thought that would be fixed by now since I updated to a more recent version of immersive engineering than what I've played with. But maybe not. Maybe I'm just imagining it. Basically, you right-click it with the hammer, and then you just log out and log back in, and then it works fine. So I'm not sure. I thought that had been patched. I know it's been patched in the 1.8 and 1.9 versions of immersive engineering, but maybe not in this version. Either way, it doesn't really make it. It's not that big of a deal. So we will get this going, and this will slowly turn into creosote oil and coal coke instead of regular coal. Let's grab our iron out of here, and we're just going to get as much of this stuff smelting up as we can so that we can make a few very important things. Okay, so now I want to go ahead and make a couple of dollies. Let's grab some of these acacia planks here, and we'll make that, and there we go, 3 dollies. So I can pick up all 3 of these chests and everything that's contained inside of them, which is super good. And I don't actually need... Well... Yeah, I don't need this. I don't need this stuff. Yeah. We're good. I was considering making next level Tinker's tools right away, but I don't think I'm gonna do that. Simply because I don't think I have the stuff. Actually, I could maybe get away with aluminum brass, because I think I've got aluminum and copper in relatively decent quantities, but at the same time, that's just going to be more stuff that we have to haul, and I don't really need all that stuff right this very second, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. Here we've got our creosote going. Man, this thing is either really buggy. I should have more than 500 creosote oil, for sure. Something that's acting funky. I may use the railcraft one instead. Let's see, coke oven, here we go. And that one's just sand and brick. And then it's 3x3 hollow. That's actually cheaper than the one that I was using before. Yeah, I think when we get to that point, we're just going to go ahead and use the railcraft one instead. They work exactly the same, and I think even statistically they're pretty much the same. I just like the way the immersive engineering one looks just a little bit more. I think it's a little bit better looking. But it's not really working properly, so yeah, we'll go with the railcraft one, I guess. Not a big deal. All right, guys, I am back, and I think I've got everything now that I need to make the Tinker's knapsack. So we're going to put the aluminum brass there, the iron tough rods there, and there we go. We've got ourselves a knapsack, which essentially is just extra inventory storage. Now, I'm not sure. Oh. I'm not sure if I... it does work as I hoped it would. Awesome. Okay, so let's pack up our house. Throw all of this stuff into chests. Grab our 2 dollies, like so. Oh, I just realized it didn't bring... There's one thing that I had intended to make that I forgot to make. And that is... a sleeping bag. Like so. Beautiful. All right. Now we can pack up our stuff. The sleeping bag will essentially allow me to sleep anywhere without having to set anything down, and more importantly, without having to set my spawn. So it's a great tool for kind of exploring and heading out into the middle of nowhere to do stuff and all that kind of thing. Basically makes it so you can sleep on the go, and that's always a good thing. So I think we're going to head off in this direction. I've done a little bit of exploring because, as I said, between episodes, I had to do some stuff. There's a meteor here. There's some green over here. This I haven't really looked at. I'm basically looking for an area that's green and looks like it's alive. A little bit of a lag spike there. Oh, ow. It would also be great if I could, like, not run into cactus. good job, self. Way to run into cactus. Cactuses, cacti, however you want to say it. They're all actually, believe it or not, they're actually all correct. But anyway, I'm going to go off and explore and try to find a place to live. Where we will set up a more permanent base than our little starter house there. The starter house was actually in a really good spot because there was a lot of clay in the water around it. So we're pretty much set on clay, and we can make a lot more grout to make a much bigger smeltery once we get to wherever we're gonna go. This area here actually isn't too bad. I think this is a lush swamp. Yeah, lush swamp. And then this might be a taiga? No, I don't think so. Spruce woods. Not a taiga, but similar. But anyway, I'm gonna go looking for stuff. I'm gonna see if I can find a place that speaks to me, if you will, and I'll come back to you after I've had a look around. All right, guys, I am back, and I think I found it. I think this is it. This is actually not a bad area. We got kind of a birch forest over here. We got the lush swamp over here. We're on an island here, and I think the island is where it's gonna be, although these trees are all gonna have to go, for sure. But I think it would be really cool to build kind of a mill, like a water mill, using the water wheels from Immersive Engineering. I think that could be really cool. So yeah, and then that can also double kind of as our early game power source as well. So let's take out our dollies and let's just plop down our three chests and throw those in here, and then we're gonna go ahead and set up our smeltery right away, because I am definitely going to want a lumber axe to clear this stuff out. So let's just set our smeltery up right here, I think. We'll go 1, 2, 3, do, 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 do. And then break that. Like so. Tank, drain, thing. Break this. And we will need the casting table. There we go. And let's grab, we've got some aluminum here, we're gonna need some copper, we're gonna need aluminum brass, and we're actually gonna need quite a lot of aluminum brass, because I'm gonna make some of the more advanced tools, and those take a lot of aluminum. Ooh, and it's night, let's sleep really quick. This island should be relatively safe once we get it cleared out, because it's surrounded on all sides by water, and mobs generally don't like crossing water very much. So I'm hopeful that we won't really have too many problems. Let's do that, and then I'm also gonna need to make a tool station as well. And I will need 4 blocks for that. Oh, and I'm gonna need more grout as well. Ah, so many things. Okay, let's grab this, let's grab this, let's grab, I know I've got more gravel. There we go. Let's go ahead and make some more grout. Oh, that's right. We need to do that. There we go. Go ahead and make a couple stacks of grout, and let's drop down a couple furnaces just right here. One stack in here, one stack in here. Grab our coal, and I'll just put half of it in each furnace and we'll call it good. And then I think I'm gonna want the casting basin here. And we obviously need our drain. So let's put the copper on the bottom. And then we'll spit a little bit more copper in there too, because we're gonna need 4 blocks in order to make the tool forge. And I will also need a few seared bricks. Is that everything? I mean, I know I need the previous thing as well. Yep, that is basically it. Okay, and here's the tool station, so I will need that. We also need the stencil table to go over here. We'll get our copper blocks. We'll get our seared bricks. And soon we'll upgrade this smeltery so it's bigger and it can process more stuff much quicker than we can do it right now. That's also very much on the agenda. Take that. Okay. And then I need to put a whole bunch of iron in here and make all the casts for a lumber axe. So that's going to take me a little bit, guys. I'll come back to you once I got it done. All right, guys, I am back, and I think I am ready to go ahead and make the lumber axe. So let's go ahead and do that. There we go, an iron lumber axe. And then the other cool thing that we can do in the tool forge is, and I think we can do this in the crafting station as well. No. Looks like we do have to do it in the tool forge. So we go here, we put our guy in here, and then do that. No, oh, you know what the problem is? It can't be damaged. It has to be full durability. There we go. And now I think I can do it over here. I'm basically just looking to replace the head on this guy. No? It says parts can be replaced. Well, I'm not sure. Repair, maybe? Maybe you can't replace the part on that? That's weird. I'm not sure what the deal is there. Either way, we've got ourselves the lumber axe, and that means clearing this island of trees is going to be a piece of cake. I love the Tinker's lumber axe so much. So much. It took me about 5, maybe 10 minutes. Do you know how long this would have taken in vanilla? Even with like an efficiency 4 diamond axe or an efficiency 5 diamond axe? Man, talk about an awesome tool. I love this thing. I absolutely love this thing. I also am a big fan of basically anything that does the same thing, so yeah. But anyway, now I'm just getting sidetracked. We also have lumber. We have wood for days. We have so much wood. It's going to be awesome. So now we can focus on building a little bit of a house. Unfortunately, I'm kind of looking at this and I'm like, Oh, also, there's all of this too. So we're going to need more chests. We're going to need to clear out some of this kind of stuff. I think I want to look into, I believe it's the sickle. Yeah, here we go. I need a stick. Let's go ahead and make one of these guys. Because this is also kind of a cool thing. That's the iron sickle from Project Red. That's not what I wanted. But it's okay. It does the exact same thing. I need to remember to fix that recipe, though. Because I like the thermal I think the thermal expansion one has a little bit bigger range or something like that. But basically what it does is allows you to clear out all of this stuff much more easily because it'll take out an area instead of just one little thing at a time. So if you want to get rid of all your nasty grass and stuff, which I do because I'd prefer to go back and bone meal it in myself in strategic spots later, this is the way to go, for sure. Okay, so we've basically got a nice big flat canvas to work with. We've got our area all kind of cleared out. We've got the trees and all that stuff moved. All is good. This is all really, really good. So now, oh, is there a nice big cave under here too that I didn't see? Because that's kind of cool if so. Anyway, so now we got to start working out what we're actually going to do for our house. Let's just finish getting that stuff picked up. There we go. And I think we should probably build ourselves another chest or two. Do I have any room left in any of these? A couple. Okay. I do. Iron block. Awesome. Let's make another iron chest. And there we go. And I'm just going to put all of this stuff in there. Except that pick. I need that. And then we'll go and take all of this stuff and put all of that in there as well. Beautiful. Okay, so for our house, as I said, I kind of want it to be like a windmill. Well, not a windmill, so much as like a water mill. And I think that means it kind of has to go on the water. And I'm thinking over here, maybe? Or maybe on this side. This side's deeper, right? Yeah, this is the side. This makes more sense. This makes a lot more sense to me to put it over here. This is deeper water. It just seems like naturally this is where it would go. So let's go and start kind of laying out a little bit of a foundation. Let's go one. Let's see. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Let's do that. So it'll be a 13 block front. I think some of this is going to end up getting peeled back as well. Just by a couple blocks. I don't want to get rid of this whole thing, but an amount of it I do. And then let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's 7 right here. And we'll build that up and kind of over the water. 4, 5, 6, 7. That should line up. Yes, good. Okay. And we'll just bam. All right, so that kind of gives us our base shape. And then we need to kind of make this a lot more interesting, because right now it's not. So let me kind of work out some ideas here, and I'll come back to you in just a sec. All right, guys, I am back, and I went ahead and I also made myself an excavator, or at least I did now, and I'm making one of the most important things for, well, I shouldn't say that. I should say one of any modded builder's favorite things right here, the chisel. I absolutely love this thing. So, and I went and I gathered up some spruce, although there it is. I was going to say, I'm not sure exactly where I put it, but I found it, so we're good. So the spruce has a lot of really cool textures, and there's, well, actually all the woods have a lot of really cool textures, but the spruce especially. And I'm kind of thinking I want this windmill slash, well, watermill slash, whatever you want to call it. I want it to appear kind of beat up, if you will. So I'm thinking we'll do a texture kind of like that. And we'll probably mix in some other textures too, kind of as we go along here. That is actually not the right place, is it? Nope. This would be, right? Yeah. And that'll have to come out and be replaced. And then I don't know about bringing that down farther. Maybe we'll do some other texture over there. Maybe like a, I don't know. We'll figure something out. But we'll do something like this, I think. And then this will be just a nice real simple texture, nothing fancy at all. And then we'll take our excavator and get rid of all of that good stuff. And then fill in as much of this as we can to get rid of the water. Do-do-do. Because I don't want water inside my house for what I would hope would be obvious reasons. There we go. Okay, so we'll get something like that. Now, this will ultimately be a floor. I think our entrance is gonna go maybe here, maybe here. Do I like that better? Kind of far side? I think so. And then we'd have, let's see, let's think about windows. So we'd have a window here and here, maybe? Yeah, that should be good. That should be good. Okay, cool. Let's grab ourselves some oak planks as well. I know I've got some. There we go. And let's just make some of those up. And we'll do a little bit of a smoother texture here. Maybe this one. this kind of smooth oak plank. I like this for, I like the smooth plank texture just in general. I kind of wish it was the default vanilla texture, to be honest, but it's not, so it's okay. There we go. And there we go. And we'll make that one oak as well. Okay, so that seems good. That seems good. Now, we need to build that up and kind of work out the frame and the shape and stuff like that. And that could take me a little bit. So let me see what I can come up with. All right, guys, I am back and we've got the majority of the building done. Pretty straightforward. I don't have the roof on that side finished, but I've got the roof shape kind of nailed down. And I think I like it. I think it works. It's very simple. And it's in kind of a style that I've been building a lot in lately. The water wheel will go right here, which I think will look really good once we get that all in place. Let's actually... This is dark oak, right? Yes. Let's actually do one of those to kind of... Yeah, that's better. Okay. So get that going. I'll have to figure out what I want to do with these little sections here that are kind of underneath the water, but I can figure that out at a later time. So now I think what we need to do is we need to get a water wheel on it for sure. And there's a bunch of stuff that I'm going to need for that. And I'm already, these chests, they go so quickly. How do I go through chest space so ridiculously fast, man? Okay, well, let's make another iron chest, I guess. I'm gonna have so many of these things by the time... Oh, man. That's all right. It's fine. Okay, let's put a bunch of this stuff away. There we go. And I think I'm going to head off and try to find myself some sand. I've already got myself clay. Sand is what I really need. And I suppose I could actually just take it from here. You can just kind of use the excavator. And if we do this properly, we can maybe even make it look kind of natural. Yeah, that's not bad. There we go. That's actually a relatively decent amount of sand. Let's get as much of that as we can. Because I want to make the coke oven from Railcraft instead of the one from Immersive Engineering. I already made the one from Immersive Engineering, but that one doesn't work very well. So I'm going to go for the other one. I'm going to go for the tried and true Railcraft one. The one that's been around the block. The one that knows its stuff. That's the plan. We're going to go with that one. So let me get the resources for it together, and I'll come back to you in just a second. All right, guys, I am back, and I think I have everything now to go ahead and make this guy. And we need... 26 of these, and I think that should be enough. And then it's a 3x3, and we're just gonna set that up. We'll just set it up over here for the moment. And it's hollow on the inside. There we go. So, there's our other coke oven. Now, unfortunately, I don't actually really have any coal left. I pretty much have used it all. So I'm going to go ahead and make myself a Tinker's Hammer so that I can go mining. And I'll do that, I think, between episodes for the most part. We'll go down here and we'll do some mining and stuff like that. And I'll come back with more resources and more goodies. And then we'll dive right back into it. But I think I am out of time for this episode, guys. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it. And it really helps up my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.